Welcome to Department of Electronics and Telecommunication at Vidya Alankar Institute of Technology. In this department, we have taken this new initiative to start our own YouTube channel. In this YouTube channel, we are going to upload all our experiments video, value-added course video, or any other important videos. This material will be available to all the students in Mumbai University, and this material will help students to enhance their learning, not just in their classroom, but even outside the classroom. I hope that everyone will like this our effort, and in case of any query, comments, anything, they can put it in comment box. Thank you.
Hello everyone, welcome to Digital Electronics Lab. Today we are going to perform experiment number 8, titled Study of Flip-Flops Using Logic Gates and IC. So let's first understand how to construct SR flip-flop using NAND gates. This is a basic circuit diagram of SR latch using NAND gates. We connect the first gate of 7400IC and give S input to it and R input to the second gate, and clock is given simultaneously to pin to one input of gate 1 and one input of gate 2. The output of gate 1 and 2 are given to gate numbers 3 and 4 respectively, and then output of that is given to as input to this gate, and this input is given from the output of this. So now we get Qn, and this is Qn bar. So now let's verify the output. Made the connections as we have discussed. So now this is the S input, this is the R input, this LED number 4 is Q, and this is for Q bar. Let's just power it on. So now we can see that in the previous state Q bar is on and Qn is 0. So now we have made S input as 1. So we should get Qn as 1 and Qn bar as 0. So we'll give the clock now. As you can see, now Qn is 1 and Qn bar is 0. And now for reset condition, we should get Qn bar as 1 and Qn 0 is equal to 0. So we'll get another clock. So now you can see Qn bar is 1 and Qn is 0. And the truth table is verified. So this is the pinout for IC7476, which is a JK flip-flop IC. It has two flip-flops. So to verify JK flip-flop truth table, which is given over here, we'll use only one flip-flop, that is J0 and K0. We can see that J0 input is given to pin number 4, K0 is given to pin number 16, output is taken from pin number 15 and 14. 14 gives us Q1 bar and 15 gives us Q. And clock is applied to pin number 1. So now let's verify the truth table. Okay, now let's verify the truth table for JK flip-flop using IC7476. There is no way out. You have to learn the pin diagrams of IC7476 to verify the truth table for JK flip-flop. As you can see, for J0 and K0, Qn bar is 1 and Qn is 0. If we make J as 1 and give a pulse, clock pulse, you will find that Qn is 1 and Qn bar is 0. Similarly, if we make K as 1 and J as 0 and give a clock pulse, you will find Qn bar is 1 and Qn is 0. Hence, truth table is verified for JK flip-flop. Okay, so this is the pin diagram for IC7474, which is a D flip-flop IC. It has two D flip-flops inside this, that is delay flip-flop. So we have to verify the truth table for D flip-flop. We'll use only one flip-flop out of this two. This is the truth table for D flip-flop, that is for 0, data 0, when we apply clock pulse, we should get output at 0, and for data 1, we should get output 1 after the application of clock pulse. So data is given as pin number 2, and clock is given at pin number 3, and Q is taken from pin number 5, and Q bar is taken from pin number 6. So now let's verify the truth. Okay, so now we have made the connections according to the pin diagram of IC7474, which you have to learn, you have no other choice. So now you can see for data input 0, you are getting Qn bar as 1 and Qn as 0. Now if you make data as 1 and apply a clock pulse, you will get data Q as 1 and Q bar as 0. And the truth table for D flip-flop is verified.
Thanks for watching.